Kat. I am coming to you from Detroit, Michigan. A couple of quick things here. I'm building two of my favorite cocktails for you today. One of them is actually an amalgamation of a cocktail from the Violet Hour in Chicago. My owner, Dave, used to live in Chicago. And he kind of brought the craft cocktail thing back with him. He used to drink at the Violet Hour quite a bit, so we have a pretty cool relationship with them. It is an amalgamation of their cocktail called Juliet and Romeo. I am making something called Starcrossed for my cognac classic alteration here. So it's 1.5 ounces of Merlot Brothers Blend Cognac. I believe the Brothers Blend is really beautiful because it's something that's made for cocktails. There's not too much wood, there's not too much age. And then we're going to do 1/2 ounce of lime juice. And then we're going to do about 1/2 ounce of simple syrup. I use 2-to-1 Demerara, a little extra roasty, toasty goodness and sweetness in there. Probably my favorite part about this cocktail is how approachable it really is and can make cognac be. I think that's very important. So we're going to throw somewhere between 5 and 7 good mint leaves and a few cucumber slices in with that. It's a little light and bright. Something that everybody can relate to. Mint, cucumber, things that people recognize. Detroit is going through a very strange kind of upheaval of people coming back to the city and drinking craft cocktails. So it's important for us to make sure that in our quest to explore and have knowledge, that we also make things relatable. So that's something that I'm trying to do here. My second cocktail is my custom creation. It's something called the Pear Trap. Detroit has a lot of French heritage. Pears are very important to French agriculture, and so I wanted to feature that in the drink. I am doing 1.5 ounces of Merlot Cognac. Half an ounce of salted pear syrup. Half an ounce of the bouillon pear liqueur. Which also made it very easy to choose. It's earthy, it's fresh, and it doesn't have any of that kind of artificial thing to it. It's really beautiful. All of the natural maceration of the pears makes it a natural choice for a cocktail like this. And then some lime juice, about 2.5 ounces. 0.25 ounces there. Just to bring up a little acidity. We'll start with those two and then we'll finish up with the between the sheets here. We won't do that. I brought along the Two James Distillery Nain Rouge Absinthe from Detroit, and we'll do a bit of orange expression here. Orange flower water to finish them off. All right, between the sheets, let's roll. 1 ounce. One here. 1 ounce. White rum. Two ounces. I do. Simple, take some of that edge off of all of that alcohol that we just put in. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for having me out from Detroit today. It's been a pleasure and an honor, and I hope you enjoy everything. Thank you.